best point performance of the regular season, his first here in Kissimmee. Five of the next seven games included tonight are home for Osceola. So let's see if Matt McCall can continue cooking here tonight. Back to you, Nick.
Yeah, that home cooking is the recipe for Osceola. They're 6-6 at home this regular season. Just 12-3 on the road, though. They've been completely different teams. In fact, that man right there, Trevor Queen, was talking about it on last night's telecast. As we're ready to get things underway, let's get you the starting lineups for both these teams. That man returning back to the lineup, Trevlin Queen, with Jeff Howard, DJ Wilson, Mie Aoni, and Mac McClung. The Nets will go with Jalen Martin, Jacob Gilliard, Kyler Edwards, Jordan Hall, and David Muoka. Two names missing for the Nets. We'll talk about it as we go on. But having a guy like Trevlin Queen back in the lineup, that's a big lift for Osceola, Chucky.
Absolutely. Trevlin is a guy who can do a multitude of things. He's a playmaker, and he's also a scorer attacking the basket. So look for him to have a big impact on the game tonight.
Two new starters for tonight's game in the Long Island lineup, David Muoka and Jordan Hall. As Kaiser Gates, a scratch tonight. He had a nice game on Friday. He's just scratched with an injury. And then Noah Clowney, the first-round pick from last year's draft, had 18 points, 12 rebounds last night. He was a real problem for Osceola. He got called back up to the parent club. So Long Island a bit shorthanded this evening as we get underway. Nets win the tip. Kyler Edwards controls. And we got a whistle already.
Clock.
Clock did not get started. And we'll go back to Long Island. Our officials this evening, Danielle Scott, the crew chief, Kelsey Reynolds, and Jacob Barnett, the three that will officiate the game this evening. Long Island with the white uniforms, Osceola on Puerto Rican Heritage Night for the second straight night in red unis. They were in the Marvel themed jerseys last night, that Spider-Man motif. Tonight it's Puerto Rican Heritage Night. Red jerseys, red shorts, tossed into the corner, dumped off. Gilliard, three to shoot, gets up and under, missed the shot. Muoka battles it back out, and it's swung around. Martin, three ball, no. And the long rebound corralled by McClung. Magic wanted to push last night off a miss. They do again, and that's what Mac does well.
Yes, I think that when the Magic are in transition, that's when they're playing their best game. Great defense leads to fast break offense for them.
Here comes Hall down the middle. Lob for Muoka, and he dunks it down. And that was a big problem last night for Osceola's defense. When that dribble penetration happens, the big has to make a choice, Chucky, and a lot of times that leaves someone open for a dunk like that.
Well, sometimes when you get dribble penetration, you know, you're going to have multiple efforts from your rotating players. And, you know, sometimes it seems like the Magic may have an issue with that sometimes. So, you know, we'll see how they get better at that.
Here comes Hall again. That time he kept it but missed the bunny. Leak out ahead to Queen, and it's stolen by Long Island. Here comes Martin. Swung around, Gilliard back down into Martin. Wilson there to contest, and a loose ball controlled by Jet Howard. Frenetic pace early. Oni, extra pass, McClung. Out Wilson trailing. He's gonna take it to Gilliard, and the runner just doesn't stay down.
Good ball movement by the Magic early on.
There's a knockaway. Hall jumps on it. Gilliard to Martin at the top. Corner three ball. Doesn't go, and Queen has the rebound. Mentioned Trevlin missing Friday night's game due to an ankle injury. Good to see him back out there, and good to see that man, DJ Wilson, 25 points a night ago, and he starts off his scoring with a long ball.
Great penetration by Trevlin, you know, pushing the pace, making the defense flatten out, and finding this trailer big man who's a scorer and shooter. That's a good play for the Magic.
Hall stepping back, finds nothing. A lot missing from Long Island from a night ago. McClung swings it back out. Wilson gonna take it down inside, steps around Martin. Muoka with the block. Long Island on the break. Gilliard squares up a triple, and he hits it. You and I were watching him during warm-ups. Gilliard, he was working on just that three there from the break.
Yeah,
Oney. DJ just got one. That one doesn't stay down. Nice to see an early one go down for Osceola. They struggled in streaks shooting the three ball last night, and Long Island takes their first lead on the Hall jumper. McClung stepping in, left it short. Queen had a hand on it, but Long Island keeps it. Gilliard extra pass, here comes Edwards. He'll lay it up and in. Kyler Edwards, 19 points and 6 assists last night, and it leads to an Osceola timeout. 9-5 Long Island leads. 3.5 minutes gone by here in the opening quarter at Osceola Heritage Park. We're back in a moment. In the first quarter, Nick Runowitz alongside Chucky Atkins. Appreciate you joining us here on Bally Sports Florida. And Chucky, it seems, you mentioned this during the break, Long Island early trying to do something they didn't do a night ago. That's get out and run a little bit.
Absolutely. I mean, I'm pretty sure they had the opportunity to go back and watch the film from last night's game. And they've made, you know, getting up and down the court and making a transition offense an emphasis for tonight, because the majority of their points that they've scored up this point in the first quarter have all been off of, you know, transition baskets.
Edwards pokes it away. Ball will stay with the Magic. Here comes Howard. Runner. That goes down, and that breaks the 6-0 Long Island run.
Great play by Jet. Normally shooting the ball from the perimeter, but this time it's electing to attack the basket and get him an easy one.
Hey, he only had 6 points last night, but and a whistle here. This is an offensive foul, a moving screen. David Mwaka. But going back to Howard, he only had 6 points last night. 3 of them the biggest points of the night. A free throw to give Osceola a 3-point lead, and then off his own free throw miss, a two-handed dunk that iced the game for the Magic.
As a player, if I come into a game and I only had 6 the night before and I'm playing the same team, you know, I'm going to come out the next game and be super aggressive and try to make sure I can get out and get off early.
Lob inside. That was to DJ Wilson amongst a few bodies. Martin the other way. Missed the layup. Rebound Oney up ahead. Wilson. And he's going to take it down and dunk it. Did he even dribble it there? Maybe once?
I don't think he dribbled it at all.
Some long steps from DJ Wilson, who caught it just outside the three-point line.
That's the advantages you have when you're 6'10". You can catch it and take those long strides and get to the basket without putting it on the floor.
Long Island got the switch. Martin inside. Pass changed. It's out of bounds. Last touched by Long Island. And so you mentioned the last few times down the floor, the Magic defense gets set, they get stops.
Yeah, I mean, I think that, you know, every team does a great job of scouting. So when teams are able to set up defensively, they're pretty much hard to score on.
Queen backdoor, McClung got loose.
Good pass by Trevlin Queen. Catching Mac McClung going backdoor for a reverse layup, great job.
His third assist already. We're just about midway through the first quarter. Muaka can't get the up and under. Here comes Jet. He is aggressive here. Drawing the contact, missed the layup, thought he should have had the call. Long Island rebounds and runs. Hall fakes the pass, back to the top. That's Gilliard, he can't get the three, but a long rebound back out to Long Island. Gilliard, second chance, no, and here come the Magic. Dump back Queen, and he's fouled. That's a good foul by Gilliard, because Queen's going to punish the rim there.
Yeah, that's a great play. Stop a for sure two baskets, make him earn them at the free throw line. But one of the things that I like that the Magic are doing, and is one of the reasons why you like Trevon Queen in the lineup, is the fact that he gives you another ball handler. He also gives you another playmaker. And in these games like this, the more playmakers you have and ball handlers you have, it makes it easier for everyone else. And like I said, I think that he'll have a big impact on tonight's game, and he has already up to this point in the first quarter.
It's an 8-0 Osceola run. Magic open up a 4-point lead. This, a wayward pass, fortunately collected by Long Island. Edwards crashing in, gets up close and scores. Edwards with 4 early points, as I mentioned. He was a thorn in the Magic side, 19 points on Friday night. But if you're just joining us, Long Island without 2 of its starters from a night ago. Noah Clowney, the first-round pick. As that three goes down for Trevon Queen. He's feeling it after a night off.
Yeah, he got fresh legs. You know, these guys have played a lot of games here in the last week. Sometimes fresh legs beats everything.
That's right. Hall bounced inside. Back out to the top. This is Keon Johnson, who checked in at the last dead ball. Johnson fading, firing, and making. Keon Johnson for the second straight night looking smooth. He had 18 points and 8 rebounds a night ago. Wilson keeps the ball up high. Floater is good. Nice soft hands there from DJ Wilson.
Yes, sir. DJ Wilson is having a good night. He's off to a really good start. For a big man, he can stretch it to the three-point line, and he also has the ball-handling ability to get past his man and make a play at the rim.
Edwards rises and misses. Ball volleyed around, collected by Long Island, out to the corner, and that is up and in from the wing for the Nets. That's Keon Johnson. He has the last 5 for Long Island. This was a bit of the story last night, Chuck. Long Island made a ton of threes in the first half. Magic struggled. They were 5 of 20 in the first half. And then Osceola made 6 threes in the final 2 quarters in order to put that game away. Offensive rebound, Trevon Queen. Up and in, and the foul. He does look fresh.
He looks fresh, man. And also, a night off when you're watching your compadres play gives you that boosted energy to want to get back out there and compete with them.
Especially a game like this, as you see Queen with the putback. Trevon with 5 points, 3 rebounds, 3 assists in the first 8 minutes. But of course, both these teams come in with not just playoff aspirations, but high seeding aspirations. Queen can't get the free throw. Magic atop the Eastern Conference standings at 18-9, a half game in front of Delaware. Long Island, with the loss last night, fell from 4th to 6th. They're 2.5 games back of first and lead in that 6th spot by 2.
Right. And you also have to take into consideration that this is a statement game, right? We know that, hey, we're one of the tops in the East and that we could possibly see each other in a playoff setting. So, you know, we got these guys at our place, and we want to set the tone and let them know that, hey, this is what you're good to look forward to come playoff time if you ever come back here.
How about the work from Chris Walker there? Had the tip back, missed it, and then put it back up and in off his miss. Rebound. Loose ball collected by the Magic, plowed into Queen to the middle. Morales steps in and lays it up and scores. Timeout, Long Island. Magic really starting to feel some rhythm here.
Yes, sir. I mean, they're doing a really good job of keeping those guys out of the paint now, making them shoot contested shots, and getting out and running, and you know, and that's their strength.
Magic lead by 8. Thank you.
changer in our community. For more than 22 years, with Simon Garcia and raising awareness on the impact of domestic violence, sexual abuse, throughout Santa Rosa, we provide workshops, safety and self-defense classes to children and adults, for compassion supporting with younger children. So much so that you come to the Oscar Autonomous School Board, where our main priority will be the safety of our children. As final, I have recognized as an exemplary leader that shows faith and beyond to help the community. That's it. Let's give it one time for our community game changer, Osama.
Magic lead 24-16, 3:19 left in the first quarter. Appreciate you joining us. Some NBA G League basketball on Bally Sports Florida as your Osceola Magic host the Long Island Nets for the second game and second night in a row. Magic winners last night over this Long Island team, 123-117. That man right there, Mac McClung, had 33 points. Tonight, Chucky, Treble and Queen leading the way, 6 points, 4 rebounds, 3 assists, and he takes a seat on the bench.
Absolutely. Trevlin has played exceptionally well early on here in the first quarter. And again, he makes it a lot easier for the guys like Mac McClung and the DJ Wilsons, because he's a guy who can handle the ball and take some of the pressure off of them.
Corner three up for Long Island. That doesn't go. Gardner reaching inside, lost it out of bounds. Might be one worth taking another look at is Dylan Murphy's thinking about whether or not he wants to challenge. He'll elect not to. Let's get another look. And Daquan Plowden poked that one out of bounds, out of the inbound, a block for the Magic. I think it was McClung that got a hand on it, and now a turnover. Magic have numbers. Here comes Plowden, he's fouled. And Daquan fortunately gets up quickly there. That was a bit of an undercut by the defender. Another look here.
Yeah,
that's a dangerous play by Keon Johnson.
Yeah, dangerous play. But, I mean, you know, to play that, it's hard to control. You got a guy like Plowden coming in at you full speed, bearing down on the rim, putting pressure on you. You know, sometimes hard fouls happen.
Plowden out of Bowling Green, 6 points last night, 89% free throw shooter. He splashes that one. And the Magic lead by 10. They fall into that zone defense. Edwards bounces inside, and Johnson lost it on the way up.
Good hands by Plowden. Able to get his hands on the ball and force the turnover.
Lob to Walker, and it goes off of him. He talked about adjustments from Friday to Saturday. It feels as if the Magic saw in their scouting report that that lob is open, because they've been trying in this first quarter to make that work.
Well, I think that they'll be able to get it, you know, the lob, that is, in the second half. I think in the first half, I think everybody's kind of looking for that type of situation. But they're off to a good start. And, you know, the thought process is to come out and win the first quarter, right?
Mm-hmm.
So here we are with 2 minutes to go. The Magic up 25-18, so everything is status quo up to this point.
Warren jumper is up and in. On the other side, Mac McClung answers with a triple try of his own. And Osceola back to an 11-point lead. Nice move inside. That's Davion Warren with his second straight bucket. Had 7 points in 9 minutes last night. McClung, no look down inside, and Trey Scott able to just get that over the rim. Almost got dunked, but almost got blocked by the rim there.
Yeah, rim probably came up on him faster than he expected it to.
Warren inside, taking on Walker, he draws the foul. Basket won't count, but we'll see. Davion Warren head to the free throw line. Another look. Walker just reaching in there. And we'll see him head to the free throw line. Long Island shooting 37% from the floor in this opening quarter, just 2 of 7 from three. The Magic, how about this, Chucky? 61% from the floor. They're feeling good right now.
Yeah, and they should. You know, they're playing solid defense, and they're able to let their athletes get out and run once they play solid defense. You understand what I'm saying?
Toss inside. Morales couldn't get the put back. He's fighting with Gardner for it. Long Island in transition up ahead, and that's Warren, who's upended and will earn another trip to the free throw line. Another look. Plowden just didn't time it quite right there.
One of the things that has happened the last minute is the fact that the Magic has went back and switched their zone and went from being man-to-man to a zone, and they're starting to give up little penetration to the Nets. You know what I mean? They had a good little rhythm where they were playing really good defense, making them shoot over contested shots. And then I understand Coach Murphy wanted to try to switch it up a little bit and change his defenses up, but sometimes when you change your defense up, it doesn't have the same amount, it doesn't have the same pressure or the same energy.
And that's an interesting point to make as well, because you're kind of focused on that zone, and then when you make that change, there are some adjustments to make as McClung draws the foul, and that's kind of what you've seen the last few possessions here.
Yeah, absolutely.
So 9-point Magic lead McClung to the line, another look. And right there, easily, the right hand comes down on the arm of McClung. And they did not say that was in the act of shooting. I'm a bit surprised at that. That looked like it was in the act of shooting.
Yeah, did they call a foul, or did they just call it out of bounds?
Oh, you're right. They said that was just out of bounds. Right. I thought it was a foul.
Right.
That's a good point. So a 14-second shot clock for the Magic. Another look. Why? And you see the hand on the arm there.
Right.
So not only do they not call a foul, they say it's out of bounds. So instead of two free throws for Mac McClung, he'll be inbounding the ball. And an adjustment made to the shot clock with 41 seconds left in the first. It's a 10-second shot clock for Osceola. Walker going to take it to Gardner. Shot no good. Morales with 6 to shoot. And he lost it out of bounds. Not quite sure if that's what you were looking for off the inbound. Is Chris Walker taking it to the rim?
No, I don't think that that's what you wanted out of the out-of-bounds situation. But I can understand, you know, the shot clock running down and then the ball finds itself in Chris Walker's hand, and he's trying to make a play to be aggressive, kind of get himself in the rhythm of the game.
Kennedy Chandler got the step on Morales, missed the shot. Long Island again nearly had the offensive rebound. Walker in transition, dumps it down inside to Plowden, and his patience leads to a dunk. I don't know, Chris Walker had that in his bag either.
Yeah, he's gotten a lot better with his handles. You see the big man doing a great job of leading the break and making a great play to Plowden for an easy layup.
Shot clock turned off, 6 to shoot for Kennedy Chandler. Magic jump on the screen. Chandler gets inside and lays Kennedy. It up and in. Half a second left in the opening quarter. Morales won't get a shot off, and we're through one. Magic lead 33-22. We head to the second quarter here at Osceola Heritage Park.
And
Welcome back to Osceola Heritage Park, where if you're noticing, the score from the end of the first has changed, an official change. Magic lead 31-24, so a 7-point advantage instead of 33-22. We welcome you back. He's Chucky Atkins. I'm Nick Grunowitz. Appreciate you joining us. Osceola Magic finishing up a 4-game homestand to win tonight. They go to 3-1 and continue there to tighten their grip on first place in the G League's Eastern Conference. But here's a takeaway on the opening possession. Edwards dunks it down and draws the foul. Was not afraid of Chris Walker, and he earns an extra 3-point play opportunity.
Big time play. Good steal, shielding off Chris Walker with his body. And I guess he kind of figured that Chris is such an athlete that he was going to try to meet him at the rim. So he didn't even give him an opportunity. He went there with intention to dunk it as soon as he gave him the body. Great play, pro play.
Edwards, 19 points, 6 assists on Friday when these two teams played. 65% free throw shooter. That one's up and in. I guess I should say, I forget to say this from time to time, if you are new to G League basketball, the free throw rules are a little bit different. If you're tuning in and watching us on Bally Sports Florida and are used to the NBA rules, in the G League, you shoot free throws for 1, 2, or 3 points. Walker with a putback up until the 2-minute mark of the fourth quarter. So all free throws will be a single attempt worth 1, 2, or 3 until the 2-minute mark of the fourth, and then we get back to traditional rules. Three ball rims out. Walker fighting for it with Gardner. No. Swung back out. Cross court pass. That's a nice one. Edwards wide open, and he splashes it. What a look from Jordan Hall. Cross court into the corner.
Great play. Second chance opportunity, finding a shooter wide open in the corner. Shortest spot on the court for a three.
Plowden blocked from behind. That's Jalen Martin, the overtime elite alum. Gilliard back into the game and back to work. Edwards blocked that time. And here's David Muaka. He's fouled. And more free throw opportunities coming for the Nets. Looks like that's on Trace Scott. And you see him get the arm there. That's two on the Magic and the first on Scott. Muaka did not play in last night's game. Missed his second straight. Heads to the free throw line. Had 2 points in that first quarter. And the 2-point free throw goes down. It's a 3-point game.
The Magic has to do something to try to be able to sustain their energy, you know what I mean, defensively. Defensively, they haven't been looking the same as they were the first, say, 8 minutes of the first quarter.
And they throw a double there at Howard. It creates another turnover, and here come the Nets. Gilliard, transition three. He knocks it down, and we're knotted up at 33. 10:21 left in the second quarter. Long Island up by two, make that, as we're just underway in the second. We're back in a moment. Long Island on an 11-2 run to open up the second quarter. Nets lead by two, and you see Mac McClung, who returned last night after an extended absence. The Magic missing another member of their backcourt this evening. More on that from Wendell Epps.
Thank you very much, Nick. Kevon Harris played last night against Long Island, scored 18 points, grabbed 4 rebounds in 32 minutes of play, but he's out tonight with a knee injury for Kevon. So pretty big loss for Osceola, but of course we got plenty of guys like Matt McClung, Trevlin Queen, Jet Howard out here tonight that'll be looking to fill in the void. Back to you guys.
Appreciate that, Wendell. Chucky, you and I were talking about that during the break. So many ball handlers on this Osceola team that it's tough to lose a guy like Kevon whenever you do,
right.
But the Magic do have ball handlers that can fill in.
Absolutely. Again, when you're out here in this type of atmosphere with so many good players, the more ball handlers you're able to have, it makes it easier on everyone out there, because you're playing a lot of games throughout the course of a season, and you don't want to be the sole ball handler on any team, because at some point in time you're going to wear down.
Gilliard looked to step back, finds Edwards. Magic tied up on the putback by Daquan Plowden. 8 to shoot Gilliard. Driving underneath. Circles. Back out right wing. 3-ball Martin. No. And the Magic corral the rebound. Defensive rebounds also need to be a focus for the Magic. Long Island's had some second chance opportunities.
Yeah. I mean, a lot of times when you're playing and you're giving up dribble penetration, the bigs having to step over sometimes leads to teams getting offensive rebounds on them, too.
Chris Walker with his 5th and 6th points of the night. Here comes Hall. Backing down on Howard, steps in. Slashing and a foul called. And is that Jalen Martin? No, it's Edwards. And he's shaken up. Another look. And it looks like Howard got him on the head.
Yeah, he hit him in the head.
Edwards is still down.
Well, he may have gotten hit with an elbow in the head.
May have. Edwards slow to get up. He does. And we'll head to the line. 10 points for Edwards in the first half. So for the second straight night, he's proven to be a handful for Osceola. 4 of 7 from the floor. His second trip to the line, he made the earlier attempt. All 5 starters for the Nets are on the floor. Martin, Hall, Muoka, Gilliard, and Edwards at the line. Magic mascot Swish trying to will this out of the cylinder, but Edwards knots it up at 37. Alex Morales has checked in, and Hall deflects that back behind the backboard. Jet Howard tried to find Morales in the corner. From Dylan Murphy's reaction there must have been some sort of miscommunication on what the Magic were going to run.
Sometimes that happens.
Howard, Wilson, Oney, Morales, and Plowden, the 5 out there for Osceola. DJ Wilson, 7 first quarter points. Here's Oney inside, back out to the top. Wilson sizing up Muaka. The jump hook, no, left short. Fading a little bit away from the rim there.
Yeah, good move, tough shot.
Into the corner, Edwards. Down inside, and that one's blocked by Morales. Taken by Howard. Up ahead, there's Morales. Good passing in transition.
Yes, again, that's when the Magic are at their best. Getting stops, getting out, pushing, everybody running, being athletic, getting up and down the court.
Edwards in the lane. Forces it up.
4 shot.
Morales again, Plowden up close. No, they call an offensive foul here. Edwards hits the parquet. Let's get another look at this one. This felt like a bit of a bang-bang play. What are your thoughts on that one, Chucky?
I don't necessarily agree with the call, but, you know.
It's one of those where if you challenge it, you don't know if you can get it overturned, but it's a 50-50 call.
Right, and it's still early, relatively early in the game, so don't use necessarily a challenge right there in that play.
Not a big enough moment.
Right.
Hall trying to turn the corner on Oney. Mooka back to Hall. Bounce Gilliard. Good step to the corner. Three ball up. No good. Mooka with the offensive rebound. Dipping it inside. It's a turnover. Here come the Magic. Mie Oney tripped up, but Morales is there. Trevelin Queen has checked in. They go high low to Plowden. And here's an intercepted pass by Pierre Louis. Gilliard, transition three, bags it. Jacob Gilliard was working on that three ball during the pregame shoot-around, and he's got it sighted in. Gilliard with 9 points. DJ Wilson to the rim, and his layup too strong. Gilliard again from deep. He strikes it. Long Island, 6 of 14 from three.
Yeah. You can't keep leaving Gilliard wide open.
Oney, no. Plowden trying to tip it back, but here's, once again, Keon Johnson and the Nets into the corner. Another three ball goes up, and that one just jumps out. Magic dodge a bullet. Up ahead, Morales creeps in behind the defense. He's down. Thought he should have had a foul. 5-on-4 Long Island. Gilliard, heat check.
And an
offensive rebound. Morales is still down. No stoppage. Magic feel like they should have one. And a three is up and in for Long Island. Still a player down and still no whistle. And finally, Dylan Murphy incensed. Morales still hasn't gotten up. And Dylan Murphy, giving everything he's got to this officiating crew. That's Jacob Barnett.
And he has every right to be upset, right? A guy's down, and we've had the opportunity to have an offensive break, an offensive rebound, and you don't call nothing.
We're back in a moment here. Morales slow. Magic trail by 7, 6:02 left in the second quarter. And before we went to break, the Magic's Alex Morales shaken up after this play. You see him go down, hit the back of his head on David Hall's knee. That's what it was. And it turns into multiple opportunities for Long Island before Hall finally hit the three. It's a 9-0 Long Island run and a 7-point lead. That's one of those situations you expect the play to be whistled dead when a player is down like that.
Yes, if I'm Coach Murphy, I'm furious. A player goes down. As soon as we have an opportunity for an offensive rebound, to get the rebound, the play should have stopped immediately.
Trevelin Queen scores for the first time in the second quarter. He has 9 points, the lead down to 5 for Long Island. This has been a game of runs. Long Island started the quarter on 11-2 run. Magic built a lead back up. And now Long Island was on that 9-0 run. Ball deflected out of bounds. Last touched by Long Island. It's Osceola ball. And here come the Magic. Big difference in this game, the three-point shooting. Long Island, 7 of 18. The Magic, just 3 of 7. Howard bumps it to McClung. Mac to Queen, back to Mac. On the up fake, runner left short. Here comes Pierre-Louis. Quickly stepping the other way. That's knocked by Howard. Make it by Queen. That's off of Pierre-Louis. Pierre-Louis wants a challenge. Magic quickly restart it. DJ Wilson going to go to work. Down on that baseline. Gardner watching him. Gets under. Oney, three ball try. Knocks it down.
Big shot. Good play by DJ Wilson. Forcing the action and finding a wide open shooter on the perimeter for a wide open good shot. Magic needs that right now.
This is something you know a lot about. 12 assists on 18 made field goals.
Yes, sir. That's really, really good.
McClung dumps back. Wilson! Top four. Timeout, Long Island. We're knotted up at 46 with 4:22 to go. And once again, defensive stop leads to easy points.
Yeah, when the Magic can get back, when the Magic are back in there playing good, solid defense, 9 times out of 10, good things are going to happen for them. Being able to get out and give Mac McClung credit. He pushing the break and actually seeing everything, finding his big man and rewarding him for running hard. On the break.
DJ Wilson leads the Magic and has a game-high 12 points on 5 of 10 shooting. I mentioned the 12 assists on 19 baskets. That should be 13. We'll wait for an update there. But 13 assists on 19 baskets. A couple other numbers here in this one. Really, how about the difference here as well? 10 Magic turnovers, 17 Long Island points. That's a big number to circle there as we're late in the second quarter.
Right, that was a huge, that's going to be a huge number, right? So, again, we talk about the Nets being able to score points. Well, a lot of times they're scoring points off of Magic turnovers, as you can see.
And a little bit of confusion here as we wait to get the game restarted. I don't think they let, or they, excuse me, there was a substitution. Hall didn't know he needed to come out of the game, but Long Island had 6 on the floor there for a moment. Chandler into the game. He threw it away. Oney saves it, but right back to Long Island. And a foul called and the bucket. Pierre-Louis, his first field goal, and that's where just effort turns into unfortunate for Osceola.
Also to piggyback on that, right, this is an important game, right? So this is a game that has, what, playoff implications for the number one seed. The Magic, you can't allow them to get in ones. If you're going to foul him, put him on the floor, make sure he don't get the shot off.
How many has Long Island had here in the first half? Four, maybe five.
Mm-hmm.
Pierre-Louis acquired via trade just a few games ago. 12 points last night, and these his first points of the evening. Wilson going back to work. Patrick Gardner watching him, DJ. Howard, 5 to shoot. A little rhythm dribble, 3, no. Offensive board, Queen, back out to Wilson. He can make these, and he does.
Yes.
Game high 15 for DJ Wilson.
Trevlin Queen again, big offensive rebound. Making it happen. Filling up the stat sheet. Great job.
Keon Johnson. Bounce down low, Pierre-Louis. 3 to shoot, Johnson. Run off by Wilson, he had to double clutch it. Misses the 3. Queen has it taken away as he was looking to shovel it down. Another chance for Long Island, and a foul called. Queen thought that he was fouled on the steal when he was trying to get it out. And then Long Island earns a trip to the free throw line. Let's get another look at this one. From that angle, not much if it's on the initial shot. That's Trevelyn Queen's first foul. Fifth on the Magic, so Long Island in the bonus for the final 3:06 of this second quarter. And Edwards makes the free throw. 14 first half points for Kyler Edwards. I watch him play. I'm surprised he's not on a two-way contract. He's a talented player.
Right.
McClung trying to create some room. Got a step on Pierre-Louis. And more contact there. I'm surprised we didn't get a whistle there. 4-on-1 for Long Island. Chandler misses it. Gardner with the putback.
Patrick Gardner.
And another turnover for the Magic.
Yeah.
Johnson has it blocked by Howard. Wilson controls. Osceola's going to slow it down a little bit.
The Magic have to be careful here. They need to finish this quarter out strong.
Queen blocked by Gardner. Volleyed out to Wilson, and he couldn't save it.
Yeah.
That turnover number starting to climb. 13 turnovers for the Magic. They had 15 all of last night.
Right. You have 13 tonight, right? Then, remember, you're still in the bonus. The Nets are in the bonus for the last 2 minutes and 18. So, again, the Magic need to be extremely careful here and make sure that they can leave and get out of this quarter without letting the Nets go on an 8-0 run or, you know, get to the free throw line.
There's Patrick Gardner. Three ball up and in. Gardner with 5 first half points. Long Island is 8 of 20 from 3. Just like that, it's a 7-point game. Can you finish the final 2 minutes strong, as Chucky said? Wilson, good look inside to McClung.
Good pass. You know, DJ Wilson does a really good job for a big man, finding guys. And
there's another three from
that position.
From Patrick Gardner. Long Island gets 3 points right back and takes an 8-point lead. And for as well-oiled as the Magic offense looked in the first quarter, it's sputtering a little bit here, but that guy, who's been the guy all year long they've looked to, gets a big triple. Johnson, knocked out of bounds by DJ Wilson. On the inbound, Pierre-Louis, and that's something last night as well, Chucky. As you get a look at this game, Long Island did well all night. They got good looks off those inbounds.
Yeah, you can't fall asleep. That's totally unacceptable. Underneath, out of bounds, you're right there by the basket. You have inside position. You cannot fall asleep.
Speaking of falling asleep.
Yeah.
Trevelyn Queen with the two-handed slam. He's into double figures. 11 points for TQ.
Right now, I would like to see the Magic feature Trevelyn Queen a little bit more. He's been doing everything offensively and defensively to keep them in the game. Huge offensive rebounds, finding guys, and finishing himself with 11 points. So, you know, you have to notice that he's going right now and try to get him more involved on the offensive side of the ball.
So a pivotal point here in the second quarter. Magic have plenty of time. They can go, and well, they will go 2-for-1 here, trailing by 5. McClung dips it down low, but this is a foul on the pass. And that's against the Nets. That's Pierre-Louis. And McClung was in the active shooting. So McClung to the line for the first time. 12 first half points for McClung, 4 assists. He's 5 of 9 shooting, 33 points a night ago. Was his second straight 30-point performance. He had 36 against College Park 8 nights ago. Missed 3 games with an injury. It came right off the extended time that he missed and scored 33.
Well, if you know anything about Matt McClung, you followed his career, you know that he can score points in bunches. He's done it at every level. And, you know, it's not surprising that he'll go off for 30 points in a night. You know what I mean? That's something that he always does, and that's part of his game.
5-point Long Island lead, 3-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. McClung, 5 to shoot. Here comes Mack into the lane. Back out Oney's got to let it go. Escape dribble, triple, bottom.
Big shot.
Nice.
What a look. Gardner from her Hall from half court. No, Magic finish off the quarter with a three-pointer, and they cut the deficit to 2 as we end the first half. Chucky, couple of thoughts. We'll go to Wendell here in a moment. Couple of thoughts before we head to halftime here.
For the Magic, cut down on your turnovers, right? Maintain your defensive intensity and continue to run when you get your stops.
Our very own Wendell Epps is going to be joined by DJ Wilson here in just a moment. But a 2-point Long Island lead. DJ Wilson, 12 points, 7 rebounds. And we go down to Wendell Epps, who's with the Magic big man after a big first half.
Thank you very much, Nick, here with DJ Wilson. DJ, Long Island started in the second quarter with a 22-8 run, but you guys were able to crawl back in the second quarter at the end. What changed in that period?
I think just getting stops. You know, once you get stops and we limited them to one-shot opportunities, you can get out and run, and then that's where we got our best. So it's just a matter of getting stops and getting out and running.
What do you think needs to change in the second half if you guys want to try and finish this one?
I think just limiting them to one-shot possessions like we did when we went on that run. I think that's the biggest thing right now. So they can't run with us, you know, over the course of the next 24 minutes. If we do that, I think we're going to put ourselves in a good position to win.
All right, appreciate the time, DJ. Best luck in the second half. Back to you, Nick.
63-61, Long Island leads. Our halftime coverage continues next.
One more step. A few feet.
Time here at Osceola Heritage Park, where the Long Island Nets lead the Osceola Magic 63-61. Appreciate you joining us here on Bally Sports Florida. I'm Nick Runowitz alongside the pride of Evans High School and NBA vet Chucky Atkins. And Chucky, the first half, an entertaining one. It was a half of runs, and Long Island has the 2-point lead after two quarters. What are a couple of things you saw in that first half?
Well, I seen the Magic get off to a quick start early on, getting stops, pushing the break. And then for whatever reason, it was kind of hard for them to maintain it. The Nets came back, hit some shots. Here we are with a two-point game, the second half of basketball to play.
A lot of time left in this one, of course. Now, the big difference in the first half, Mac McClung, who's playing his second game back after missing three due to injury. McClung, 14 points in that first half. And Chucky, he's the guy the offense really takes their cues off of.
Absolutely. I mean, he's a ball handler. He's a point guard. You know, he's a guy who can make things happen, both inside and outside. And, you know, he's a guy who has a proven track record of being able to put a lot of points up on the basketball board.
You see Mac McClung just going to work here. 5 of 9 from the floor, 2 for 2 from three. And on the other side for Long Island, they're led by Kyler Edwards, 14 points, and then 10 from Keon Johnson. The bench points we'll talk about in a second, but Edwards had a special first half.
Well, he brings a toughness to the Nets. You know, he's able to get down low and use his body and draw fouls from a guard position, as well as, you know, get out on a break and finish things. So, you know, I'd like to see the Magic the second half limit their turnovers, mm-hmm. And limit, you know, the second chance opportunities from the Nets, and we'll see how this game go end up.
14 for Edwards, 10 from Keon Johnson. He led the bench mob for Long Island. 31 bench points for the Nets in that first half to just 16 for the Magic. That's a big difference in this one. Osceola shot 53% from the floor. Long Island 40%, though they did make 9 threes in that first half. So two quarters in the books. It's been an entertaining one as both these teams look to shore up their playoff positioning. It's Long Island 63, Osceola 61. We'll take a look at the standings when we return.
Education company, aiming for each specific student. All of the
Nets lead the Magic 63-61 at the half. Start of the third quarter in just a few moments. But earlier in the first half, a scary moment for the Osceola Magic as one of their top defenders, Alex Morales, goes down. And you see on the play here, Morales hits his head on the back of a player's knee. And then, Chucky, the play is not stopped, and it leads to a three in transition. Dylan Murphy not happy about
it. Absolutely. Coach Murphy shouldn't have been happy. I would have been upset myself. You know, once the play, we got the offensive rebound down here, defensive rebound, and we still got a man down on the other side of the court. The play should have immediately been stopped. And because the referees didn't stop the play, they were able to get off 2 3-point shots.
Mm-hmm.
Which led to 3 points that you actually give up. That shouldn't have never happened.
It was part of a 9-0 run for Long Island. The Nets lead by two here at the half. And this is an important game in the G League's Eastern Conference standings. The regular season ends in 2 weeks. The top six teams make the playoffs in the standings. The Magic come into tonight atop the standings at 18-9. They have a half game lead over Delaware, who's in action right now. We'll check in on that game. And Long Island, who was fourth Friday before losing to the Magic, falls to sixth. Everything's packed up here. 2.5 game difference between first and sixth.
Every game at this juncture of the season is important. Again, whether it's for standings or if it's for, you know, the playoff spots. You know, if you're the Osceola Magic, you've done a great job up to this point of having a top record in the Eastern Conference, and you want to finish it out strong so that you can maintain a home court advantage throughout the playoffs, you know, throughout the conference playoffs.
Just taking a look at that Birmingham and Delaware game going on right now. Birmingham leads Delaware 109-107, 14 seconds left in the fourth quarter. We'll talk about that game and the implications of it when we return. Third quarter also will get underway. He's Chucky Atkins. I'm Nick Grunowitz. You're watching Osceola Magic basketball on Bally Sports Florida. We're ready for the start of the second half at Osceola Heritage Park. Long Island leads the Osceola Magic 63-61 alongside Chucky Atkins. I'm Nick Grunowitz. Appreciate you joining us here on Bally Sports Florida. Our very own Wendell Epps going to be joined by Magic player development coach Ronnie Price in just a moment. But Chucky, as we start the third quarter, a couple of things the Magic need to focus on if they want to come away with a win and stay atop the Eastern Conference standings.
One, turnovers. They have to limit the turnovers. First half, too many turnovers, which led to multiple fast break points by the Nets. Two, you got to get back and you got to find your shooters. You know, I think you got to get back and find Gear. He's a guy who hurt you. And also limit those guys to one rebound and one shot. Get the rebound and push it back because that's one of your strengths.
Yeah, there was a big difference in that first half. I mentioned it, our very own Wendell Epps is with Magic player development coach Ronnie Price. We go down to Wendell Epps now.
Thank you very much, Nick. Wendell Epps here with Ronnie Price. Ronnie, what did you see out of your team in this first half? It was very back and forth. Long Island started with a big run, but you guys were able to get back into it late in the half.
The pace was fast. Just got to clean up the boards, get back in transition, we'll be in a good spot.
What have you made so far of DJ Wilson and Matt McClung? I know both of them, you know, bringing a lot of experience to the G League. What have you seen from them so far tonight?
No, they've been great for us. Just a matter of being consistent throughout the 448.
All right, thank you very much. Best of luck in the second half. Back to you guys.
Appreciate it, Wendell. Good to hear from Magic Player Development Coach Ronnie Price. And, you know, he talked about this team needing to make sure they share the basketball a little bit in this second half. But really, it is more on the defensive side, isn't it, Chucky, about limiting those second opportunities for Long Island?
Well, really with them, it's all defensive. You know what I mean? They did a really good job early on in the first quarter of contesting shots and getting out on a break and running. And as the half went on, the intensity kind of wavered a little bit. But for the most part, they were able to hold it together. But, you know, the second half, you know, the game is still in the balance. Let's see what happens here. Hopefully they'll play well enough to get the win.
And here come the Magic to open up the third quarter. Five starters that began the game. Begin the second half, DJ Wilson hands off to Mac McClung. Back out to DJ. Jet Howard catch and shoot three off the back iron. Quiet first half for Howard. 2 points on 1 of 4 shooting.
Yeah, and in order for the Magic to win, I think that they're going to have a big second half from Jet. You know, he's a guy who can make shots and stretch the court for them. So he has to really get going this second half.
That's David Muoka, who sneaks in behind the defense. Good find by Kyler Edwards. Trevelyn Queen in transition. That three doesn't go down. Magic empty on their first two possessions. And that time, Gilliard misses on the three. A little bit of jostling there between who would get the rebound.
Yeah, that happens sometimes.
Howard tries another. Can't get that one. Tipped out by Queen. Wilson from the foul line, no. This one gobbled up by Martin. He's fouled in transition by Oney.
Yeah.
So the Magic still looking for their first field goal coming out of the quarter break. And a quick stoppage here. I'm not sure what the discussion is about. That's Kelsey Reynolds, the official. I think they wanted to make it clear that it was on Mie Oney, number 33. But the five on the floor for Long Island, Jalen Martin, who we just mentioned, Jordan Hall, David Muoka, Justin Gilliard, and Kyler Edwards. Edwards, 14 first half points, gets it to Martin. Edwards dumps it inside again. Muoka with the tomahawk slam. McClung. Good move, gets inside, runner doesn't go down. Would have been a pretty finish.
Yes, great move.
Martin around the screen, out to the corner, Edwards. Long Island, we mentioned this in the first half, in a very difficult stretch in their schedule. Here's a takeaway, this time Wilson waiting for that pass. Queen to the rim, he missed the layup, got his own miss and scored. A much-needed bucket for the Magic. But I mentioned the schedule for Long Island. Nets sixth in the East right now. They'll head to take on the Indiana Mad Ants for two games after this, and then they'll play Delaware for a game as Muoka throws an elbow, misses the runner. So Long Island will finish about a week and a half stretch where they play all three of the top teams in the Eastern Conference. Wilson all alone. He got it. He's confident right now. Felt good coming out of his hands.
Well, anytime you come out early on and get off, and you can see that ball go through the basket, it gives you a great feel, it gives you a lot of confidence. So I'll expect DJ to continue to take those shots and continuously make them. And we're going to have to get him to make those to come away with this victory.
Muoka with the offensive board, Martin. Back out Gilliard to the top, Edwards. Look out. He can't get it. And DJ Wilson has the rebound. Wilson leads all scorers with 15. McClung, Queen, cross court. Wilson will take another. He didn't get that one.
Yeah. That was a heat check.
bounces right to Gilliard. He knocks it down. That was an out-of-control dribble that just took the right bounce over to Gilliard.
Yeah, they say it's better to be lucky than good sometimes.
That's an assist for Kyler Edwards, his sixth of the night. Wilson had it nearly taken away. Five to shoot, McClung. Gets inside, spins, lost the basketball. And Gilliard in transition up ahead. Martin, and he dunks it down. Another magic turnover, that's 15.
Yeah, same thing we talked about at halftime, right? Mm-hmm. If we limit our turnovers, you give yourself an opportunity. But, you know, turnovers that are leading to easy baskets, they kind of hurt you.
Toss inside, here's another turnover. Up ahead, Queen, laying in the weeds. McClung attacks. It's out of bounds. A lot of contact on that play as well. It'll be magic basketball.
Yeah, a lot of contact, and I know Max probably frustrated because he didn't get the call right here. Attacking the basket, but I mean.
I know he wanted that one, but that right. was a bit of a 50-50 call. In live time, it looked like more contact than it was.
And as players, you always think that you're getting fouled when you're going to the basket. So, you know.
There's Jet Howard. That's a welcome sight. He needs to get it going here in the second half. He's 1 of 5 from three.
I think Jet has to get it going. I mean, I would like to see him take this ball right here and be aggressive right here to the basket and make some, even force it sometimes. Sometimes you just got to force it.
And what is this? A foul against Gilliard.
He got to get going.
Long Island.
He got to get going.
That's a foul away from the ball. And Alex Morales will check back into the game. Good to see Morales back after going down, hitting his head in that first half. We showed the replay of it.
Absolutely. You never want to see anybody get hurt.
Morales, not shy, attacking again. Oney got a good look from the corner. It doesn't go. And it's volleyed out. And the Nets will get it back. They'll take a timeout on the floor. 72-69, Long Island leads. Nets basketball when we return.
Like this.
3-point Long Island lead, 6:49 left in the third quarter. We appreciate you joining us here on Bally Sports Florida as the Magic take on the Nets for the second straight night. A welcome sight here in the third quarter. Alex Morales, Magic guard, back in the lineup after suffering an injury in the second quarter. Our very own Wenzel Epps has more.
Yeah, Nick, Alex Morales, you guys just saw, just back in the game now, went down pretty hard in that first half, but he's back. It's great that Alex is back out there, especially tonight being Puerto Rican Heritage Night. 2 points, 2 rebounds so far, and Alex Morales in 9 minutes of play. Be interesting to see what he can do in the second half. Throw it back to you guys.
Appreciate it, Wendell. Morales had a big night last night, 16 points and 5 rebounds, and the Magic could use his defense. But a 3-point Long Island lead here. This is Hall in the corner. They give it back to him. Circle jumper, that is up, and that is in for Hall. He has 7 points. Chucky, we were talking about this during the break. You know, at some point in time, the Magic offense is going to go on a run, but is it going to be too late? They haven't really had an extended run since that first quarter.
Yeah, I think that, like we were talking about, that's the big question. It's not, you know, I think that they're going to go on a run. It's just when. Are they going to be able to weather the storm right now and then go on the big run, or are they going to get down by 10 and then go on a run, which will actually just make the game tie?
Rebound, Treble and Queen. Howard with 5 points already in this third. He just had two in the first half.
Yep. Like I said.
That's your guy.
Jet has to get going. You know what I'm saying? He's a guy who can stretch the court. And sometimes when you know, outside shooter like him, he has to get a rhythm. You know what I mean?
Quick start by Keon Johnson. Treble and Queen wins away the 50-50 ball. Morales, Oney, he dunks it down. Had a tight window for that pass and just snuck it in there.
Yep, snuck it in there. And this could be the start of the run that we just talked about.
Could be. See if you can get another stop here. Hall, triple try. It rims out. Wilson with the rebound. That's number 11 for DJ. Another double-double for him. Queen attacking, draws the foul. And we'll see Treble and Queen go to the line, a two-point free throw to give the Magic the lead. Another look back here. Morales, Oney, just not a lot of room for that pass to cut the deficit to one. Foul on Hall. That's his first as Daquan Plowden checks in. The Treble and Queen, after missing Friday night's game with an ankle injury, filling up the stat sheet. 13 points, 9 rebounds, 6 assists, and a steal. He leads the G League in steals per game at just a little over 3. But points 14 and 15 give the Magic a 1-point lead. Chandler Kennedy. Kennedy Chandler, make that, is checked in. Pierre Louis hands off Johnson. He has been dangerous in this series and continues to be. Keon Johnson, he's on a two-way contract with the Brooklyn Nets, continues to score and score well. 18 points last night. He averages 17 a game. Wilson to the tin.
It's a great play by Treble and Queen. Penetrating, finding the gap. Good job by DJ Wilson finding the open spot on the court, finishing the playoff.
Johnson again left that one short. Queen with the rebound. That's his 10th, a double-double for Treble and Queen. He's 3 assists away from a triple-double. One touch, fancy pass by DJ Wilson. Fancy move by Queen. He bagged it. Uh-oh.
Got him leaning.
4-point Magic lead. Their largest of the night has been 9. Chris Walker to check in at the next dead ball.
The run is on.
Can you get another stop and keep it going? And Chandler's bumped. Daquan Plowden a little too eager there. Another look here at Treble and Queen. Look at this. Watch him go by. Bottom.
Bottom's up.
Magic are shooting 51% from the floor. Treble and Queen 3 assists away from a triple-double. Out to Chandler. Magic switch. Chandler with the up fake. Now he's in some trouble. Pierre Louis got by Queen and scored. Yeah. Treble and Queen said, that one's on me. I let him beat me to the baseline.
Yeah, I think Treble was thinking that he was going to shoot the ball and, you know, not knowing that Pierre Louis is a driver, so you know you don't never want him to. Because between his jump shot and the drive, you want him to shoot the perimeter shot.
And that's a heat check 3 from Queen. He came back, touching his chest again, telling Dylan Murphy, "I shouldn't have shot that one." Gardner, undercut by Wilson, and a foul. Mac McClung will get back into the basketball game. DJ Wilson just picked up his first foul. 13 foul on the Magic. McClung with 14 points. It's good to see him back out there.
Mac was able to get a little break. You know what I mean? 3 minutes left here in the third quarter. See how we can finish this thing up.
You try to get that rest in spurts, Chucky. Tell me, like, you played in the league for a long time.
Right.
How does the coaching staff and players manage that rest side of things where you need a guy for 35, 40 minutes? You try to find any rest you can for him.
Well, the thing is you got to understand this. These guys play a lot of games in a short amount of time. So part of being a professional is being able to save yourself for the bigger moments but still be able to be productive, right? It's my understanding, like we were talking about before the game, this is their, seventh game or sixth game in nine nights?
Six game in nine nights.
So guys' legs are going to be tired. So every time you get a chance to give them a breather at this juncture of the game, it's very, very helpful.
Two of those games on the road. The Magic played last Friday and Saturday night at College Park and came home for a four-game trip. Transition triple McClung. Oh, he's hopping now. Magic have a seven-point lead. Timeout, Long Island. And there's no surprise your fortunes change when that man's on the floor.
Yes, sir. Get on the good foot, Mac.
2:24 left in the third. We're back in a moment. Two Osceola Magic run, and they lead Long Island 85-78. We welcome you back. Appreciate you joining us here on Bally Sports Florida alongside NBA vet and Central Florida man Chucky Atkins. I'm Nick Runowitz. Appreciate you joining us this evening. And Chucky, the Magic on this 10-2 run, what's fueled the run for Osceola here in the third quarter?
Just the defense and the rebounding. You know, those guys are playing tough around the basket. They're limiting the Nets to one offensive possession, one shot. And then they're getting out, sharing the basketball, and trying to get his easy baskets. Nothing.
Here's another steal. McClung puts it up, draws the foul. That is a man's play by Mac McClung.
I love it.
Let's get another look at that one. And all smiles all around. McClung up and under. And then he's got a couple of words for the defender as well.
Yeah. Speak to him, Matt. I actually thought he was going to dunk that.
So did I.
I got excited because I thought that I was going to see the NBA dunk champion get a dunk.
Somebody run Shaq out on the floor real quick. So a free throw for Mac McClung. He's 8 of 13 from the floor. Made an earlier free throw attempt. Third in the G League in scoring this year at 24 points per game. In fact, he's tied for second.
Right.
He gets the free throw.
Again, that's what Mac McClung does. If you followed him in high school and in college, you know, he's a guy that can put big points up on the board. And he's been doing a great job this year doing it for the Magic. And as you say, he's third in the league.
Edwards, extra pass down to the baseline. Swung back out to Gilliard. Here comes Pierre-Louis. Magic defense active here. Pierre-Louis to the middle. He missed the layup. A lot of energy.
A lot of energy. Guys are doing a good job just then rotate defensively. And, you know, again, a contested layup and an easy one for Mac.
15-2 Osceola run. They lead at 90-78. This is the largest lead of the night for the Magic. Gilliard, Edwards left alone. He got it. that's a guy you can't leave alone.
Yeah. I mean, on the other side of the ball for the Nets, if you got Gilliard and you got Edwards shooting the ball, you're feeling comfortable, right? So the Magic has to understand that and get out to those two guys especially. We're sitting here, right? We haven't seen.
There's McClung again.
Yeah.
Oh, he's feeling it right now.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. He done seen three of them go to the basket. He finna light it up.
27 for Mac. Keon Johnson. Edwards, 9 to shoot, into the middle. Bounce pass, Johnson attacking, and he scores off the glass.
Like I was saying before, if you're the Magic, you know that Gilliard and Edwards are the shooters. You got to do a better job in understanding and get out to those guys, right? We've been sitting here, Pierre, Louis.
Mac again. He got it. Uh-oh, he's in fuego.
Uh-oh.
30 for Mac.
Yeah, Pierre Louis hasn't shot a jump shot yet.
Johnson driving, back out Gilliard.
He's gonna drive.
Out to Gilliard, extra pass. Edwards is alone again, he got it back. 20 for Kyler Edwards.
As we speak.
He's keeping the Nets in it right now. Shot clock turned off. They're gonna let Walker bring it up. Hands off to Mac.
Heat check right here for Mac.
Oh yes.
Heat check.
There it is, draws the foul. They said that's not in the act of shooting. McClung wanted a review, and Dylan Murphy just shrugged at him. Another look. I don't think he's quite in the act there at that point. It's a close one.
Yeah, he was trying to give him the foul.
Long Island had one to give.
Right.
DJ Wilson gonna check back in at the start of the fourth quarter. They hand to Mac. He lets it fly again. The roof would have come off this place if that had been good. Transition, Gilliard, he didn't get it off, and it doesn't go anyway. Magic, we were asking, when were they going to go on a run? Well, they did. It's an 18-4 run to take a 10-point lead. We head to the fourth quarter next.
Wendell Ebbs here at Silver Spurs Arena. It was a Mac McClung show to end that third quarter for Osceola. 16 straight points for Mac to end that third period for Osceola. He's on fire. We know he had over 30 points last night against Long Island. Can he do it again? Nick, Chucky, Mac's erupting his place. His place is going nuts. It's a big game. We'll see what he can do in the fourth as Osceola looks to get the win. Back to you guys.
It's 10 at the start of the fourth. Wendell, appreciate it. McClung had 19 in the third, 19 of the Magic's 35 points, and it's a 10-point lead, Chucky.
Yep, we spoke about the run. These guys got it together. Matt got hot at the right time for his team, and they're rolling right now with a 10-point lead at the beginning of the fourth.
Gilliard missed the three ball. You'd have to think first 2-3 minutes this fourth quarter are paramount for the Magic to hold this lead.
Well, I think if you're the Magic, I think you come out to with a good start here in the third, I mean in the fourth, and put them in a position because they may quit.
There's your guy, Jed Howard.
Yes, sir.
12-point Magic lead. They've led by as many as 13 tonight. Martin. Hall bumped by Howard. He got hit in the jaw. Make it by, yeah, by Howard. That was Morales. Hall, triple try. He didn't get it, and Daquan Plowden hauls in the rebound. McClung is out there to start the fourth. Taking his time. Hall switches on him. Here comes Mack. Got inside, up and under. Good block down low by Muoka. Edwards in transition.
Ooh.
A foul called on the pass. And this is on Jet Howard, his third. Another look at it. And came down on the arm of Edwards on the pass there.
Right.
That's the first against the Magic. And the foul situation, something to keep an eye on. Long Island leads the G League in free throw attempts per game. Just about 13 a night. Edwards back to the rim. He finishes strong. This is an impressive showing from Kyler Edwards. 22 points tonight.
Yeah, he's a tough matchup. He's a guy that's strong base, big shoulders. And once he gets half a step on you, he gives you that shoulder, and he's able to finish. He has a nice touch around the basket, so as well as he can shoot the ball from the perimeter.
Alex Morales falling down. A wayward shot controlled by Long Island. Gilliard in transition, and he's tied up by McClung. Mack just with the smart foul there, want to make sure he doesn't get anything up.
Yeah, that was a good foul. You know what I mean? Make sure you don't get it. You know, you foul him, make sure he don't get it up. Obviously, his goal to the line. If I was Mack, I'd have probably stepped up and tried to get him before he got into his motion so that he could take it out on the side. But, you know, good foul. Send it to the free throw line.
This is Jalen Martin, played his post-high school season with the overtime elite. As he misses the free throw. Was the most improved player in that league. Magic get the rebound, and here comes Jet Howard. Ball in his hands here in the fourth. Morales with Martin on him. They get it to McClung. He fires the three. That goes in, and the foul. It's a Mack attack at Osceola Heritage Park.
Yeah.
Another look. Mack and Muoka got him. Nothing but net. 22 second half points for Mack McClung.
He's rocking and rolling right now. And any scorer that gets in the type of groove that he's in right now, especially when he's watching the ball go through the basket, he's going to be tough to slow down right now.
A four-point play opportunity for Mack McClung. So you go back to his last three games. A week ago, Friday, 36 points against College Park. Last night, 33 against Long Island. And with that free throw, he has 34 right now. Talk about winning time.
Don't be surprised if he gets closer to that 50 mark.
Oof. Don't get me hopeful here,
Chucky. That wouldn't surprise me. A guy like him, seeing that ball go through the basket.
Gilliard from the corner. He gets it to go. The three-point shooting of Long Island has kept them in this game. They're 13 of 33, but it's really been when they've had those makes, key moments.
Yeah, right now, I would make Pierre-Louis finish a couple of baskets, a couple shots at the basket. I wouldn't leave off of Gilliard.
Hall, Pierre-Louis camping out underneath. A couple of quick buckets for the Nets. Really now, if you're Osceola, Chucky, it's about good possessions. You want to not necessarily take time off the clock, but you want to have as many good looks as possible.
Well, stay aggressive. but at the same time, be smart and manage the clock. You know what I mean?
Morales looked like he had the rebound, but Hilliard poked it away. And here's Pierre Louis, and he draws another foul. And for McClung, that's number two.
And another thing that I would like for the Magic, what I'd like them to do is like, Plowden took that shot right there, right? Mm-hmm. You have to understand who has it going and who don't, right? That's the difference, really, from guys getting to the top level, understanding who has it going on. Right now, Mac McClung got it going on.
Long Island trails by nine. Free throws coming up. Points, Osceola lead, 8:37 left in the fourth quarter. Nate Pierre-Louis headed the line for Long Island. They can cut into the deficit, make it a 7-point game. That would also be a 7-0 run for the Nets. I'm Nick Grunowitz alongside Chucky Atkins. And Chucky, we've seen Long Island kind of stem the tide here a little bit by just getting down quickly and getting some opportunities.
Absolutely. I mean, they're in a situation where they're running out of time. 8 minutes ago, they were down by double digits, and they're going to try to up the tempo as much as they possibly can to try to get themselves within striking distance to get themselves a chance to win this game.
Free throw up and in, and just like that, it is a 7-point game and a 7-0 Long Island run. Queen, Howard, Wilson, Morales, and Plowden on the floor for the Magic. Pierre-Louis got a hand on that one, and here he comes. Bounce to Gilliard. He attracts a lot of attention. Hall. Muoka. Another hand to Gilliard. Magic go under, and that one doesn't go down. I think you look to Trevelyan Queen here to finish. Instead, it's Jet Howard. He knocks it down.
Yes. Big shot for Jet.
10 second half points for the Magic's first round pick in last year's draft, and it's a 10-point Magic lead. Keon Johnson, Daquan Plowden got up in the air and he steps under and scores. Keon Johnson, 12 points off the bench.
He's a player.
That's great.
Great footwork down there on the drive to the basket.
And Plowden triple. Volleyed out. Howard just steps into it. Why not?
Yeah. It's that time for him. Fourth quarter.
Magic lead up to 11. But as we know, no lead is safe in this league.
No, not in the shot clock here right now, the way these guys shoot three-pointers.
Johnson run off the line. Gilliard back to Johnson. He retreats to the corner. Hall, three to shoot. Down inside, Pierre-Louis missed the bunny, and Plowden has the rebound. Good defensive closeouts there by the Magic. They throw into Oney. He's being held. Plowden triple try. Left it short. Here comes Hall. No one's going to get in his way. That's a nice find by Gilliard.
Yep.
His fifth assist of the night. Hall has 9 points and 8 rebounds. Queen, two assists away from a triple-double. Trebelin, back to Howard. Could this be another one? Yes, it is. Jet Howard has caught fire in the fourth quarter.
Come on, Jet. That's a great play call for Coach Murphy out of the timeout, too.
Hall behind the back, and that is knocked away by the Magic defense. After that slow start, Osceola is now 17 of 32 from three, and you get another look at Jet Howard well above the arc on that one. There are NBA threes, and then there are NBA threes, and he's got the shrug after two.
It always feels good when you see him go in.
B.A. Oney almost had the steal there, and he's saying review it. Does a player ever not ask for a review after a call like that?
Never. You know, one thing about players, we always want possession of the basketball, and we always think we get fouled, and we never foul.
Inside, Gardner puts it up and in. It feels like the Magic are going to live with those. It's the three-point shots that they're closing out on.
Absolutely. That's the only way that the Brooklyn Nets are going to get back in a short amount of time is hit threes.
McClung, that just rims out. In transition, here comes Pierre-Louis. Three ball from Hall. That's not close. Howard up ahead. DJ Wilson, lob to Queen. 12-point Magic lead. Queen has 20 to go with 11 points. And here's another steal for Trevelin. Look out. Timeout, Long Island. Magic have their largest lead of the night. It's 14, and they're dancing.
Great energy.
.115-101, Osceola in control. We're back in a moment. That's two for Queen. Let's get him one more assist and get to a triple-double. It was Mac McClung in the third quarter. He had 19 points, and here in the fourth is Jet Howard and Trevelin Queen to the top floor. Queen with the last four for Osceola, including a steal that led to that bucket. Chucky Atkins, the defense setting up the offense here in the fourth quarter.
Absolutely. These guys have settled down. For the most part, they've taken the shooters out of play, and they're getting out and sharing the ball with one another and making all the right plays.
And you can feel the defensive intensity just step up here in crunch time. Keon Johnson every time. Now, Long Island has needed a bucket. It's been Keon Johnson or Kyler Edwards, and that time Johnson gets the bucket. But under 5 minutes to go, you can have a couple of good possessions. Jet Howard again, that one just rattles out. Queen with the board. Here comes Howard, my goodness. Look out. Rocking the rim.
Oh, yeah. This is definitely fun to watch. Again, you got to give Coach Murphy a lot of credit. Out of the timeout, they run a beautiful half-court set. driving baseline by McClung. Everybody's going to be paying attention to him because he's been torching. And you're setting the flare back screen for Jet Howard going to the corner. Great play, great execution, which leads to an offensive rebound and a finish by Jet.
Howard, after that dunk, 20 points. He has 18 in the second half. It was a slow start, but he's going now. And there's Pierre Kennedy Chandler, with the 2 points.
Great move by Kennedy Chandler.
That's a dangerous Long Island team. I know the Magic are in front by double digits, but this Long Island team is tough. Mahoney back to Queen. Mob inside, Wilson left alone, puts it up and in. Everyone forgot about DJ Wilson.
Smart play and good recognition by Trevlin Queen, understanding that the shot clock's going down and finding DJ Wilson by the basket for a high percentage shot.
That's assist number 11 for Trevlin. A triple-double tonight for the Magic two-way player. 22 points, 12 rebounds, 11 assists. Keon Johnson gets the foul and the bucket, and Dylan Murphy thought that was a travel. Second team foul on the Magic. Another look here. And that is a travel. Regardless, Kelsey Reynolds didn't see it here on the sideline. And Keon Johnson is headed to the line. 17 points tonight for Johnson. This is a 1-point free throw with 3:29 left in the fourth. And that goes down. Wilson with 10 to shoot, out to Queen. Trevlin taking his time. Step back, here's a three, no. And the rebound controlled by Long Island. Gotta be careful here, there's still a lot of time left. And Kennedy Chandler just dropped it out of bounds.
You gotta be careful, you gotta be smart at this juncture of the game, right? You got an 11-point lead with 3 minutes to go. Mm-hmm. Time is on your side. Take the high percentage shot, execute your sets, and remain aggressive.
We talked a lot about turnovers in that first half. Magic had 14. They have just 7 for the game. And there's the broadcaster's jinx.
Yep.
I'll tap my chest there. That one's on me,
yep,
Chucky.
That was on us.
The 18th turnover for Osceola. We're under 3 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter.
Continue to get shots. Continue to get good, wide-open shots.
Long Island with 4 players in double figures. Kyler Edwards leads the way with 22. Gilliard with 20. Keon Johnson with 18. And Gardner with 10. Magic looking for their fourth player above 20. That would be DJ Wilson, who's looking to get there. Chandler inside, no. Rebound, DJ Wilson, and the Magic shouldn't be in much of a hurry here. Never mind. Queen, I'm just going to get up close and score. And for the reason why I was thinking that, Trevlin Queen said go for it, because the defense was thinking that.
Right, right.
Chandler inside, missed the layup. Queen with the rebound. Here's Wilson.
Yes.
4 players in the 20-point plus territory for the Magic. Wilson with that dunk has 21. Another look. And the Magic sharing the basketball. That's assist number 31, Chucky, on 48 field goals. That's pretty.
As a coach, you love to see your team have a lot of team assists, right? I mean, you're sharing the basketball, right? You get a lot of wide open looks. And it's fun to play that way, you know what I mean?
Johnson again, dumping it off. Wilson knocked it away. Johnson got it back, and he missed the layup. But right there is Keon Johnson again. And Long Island with another score.
Right.
And once again, Mack McClung in no hurry. If you're just joining us, Magic atop the Eastern Conference standings by half a game over Delaware coming into tonight. We've been told Delaware lost earlier today, so a chance for some breathing room, and there is a breath of fresh air. DJ Wilson, my goodness.
Show off then, DJ.
23-13 for Wilson. Keon Johnson. Gardner fighting inside. Wilson stands tall. Johnson just took it away from him. Another try for Gardner, and the second try goes down. Magic can run this under a minute on this possession.
Yep. Take your time. Again, execute. Time is on your side.
This is about as good a game as the Magic have played all season long against a very tough defensive Long Island team. They're 10th in the league in points allowed. McClung, that rhythm dribble three doesn't go. Chandler missed the dunk. And Pierre Louis puts it up and scores. And in that situation, just want Oney, let him have it. Let him have it inside. You don't want the three-point play opportunity, but.
Look, again, if you're going to foul, don't let him get it up.
Oney arguing his case with the crew chief, Danielle Scott. But the Magic up by 13. This is a one-point free throw, which they all are the rest of the way. For Pierre Louis. Off the bench, 11 points tonight in 28 minutes. Quick programming note for you tonight after our game. Well, sorry, at the conclusion of our game, our very own Wendell Epps is going to speak with Mac McClung, who's our player of the night tonight. Plenty to choose from. 34 points for Mac, 6 assists. 6 of 9 from 3. Caught fire in the third quarter with 19 of those 33. Magic running it down. Howard finds Mac. And there's a kick ball, which if you're Osceola, you like, because that takes the shot clock back to 14. You can keep running the clock down here.
Absolutely. Right now, we're just trying to get out of here with the victory. Make sure no one gets hurt.
Magic will head out on the road after this. Play 2 at Birmingham before coming back home for the final 4 regular season games of the year.
Oh!
Foul the other way. And Pierre Louis came down awkwardly. He's grabbing that left leg. DJ Wilson doesn't love the call. Another look. Chucky, what do you see there?
I see him twist his ankle, really. When he was getting ready to make the move and ready to jump, he twisted his ankle right there.
Ooh, he did. Oof.
Yeah, he twisted his ankle.
No foul on DJ Wilson there. It's a flat tire. That left ankle turned.
He'll be sore in the morning, believe that.
So Pierre Louis will shoot 2 1-point free throws.
He's hurting.
10-point Magic lead. He's in some pain.
Oh, yeah, he's hurting.
And Chucky, I'd ask you as, of course, NBA vet to describe that pain, but I think everyone knows what it is watching that.
Yeah, man. When you see him turn his ankle like that right there, that pain is all the way, that's going all the way up to his knee. And, you know, he's probably going to be swollen. He's going to get up out of this game, too.
8-point Magic lead. They inbound to McClung, and Long Island will foul Mac. That'll get Pierre Louis out of the game. Jalen Martin will check back in. So the Magic are going to pick up win number 19 of the season. They'll take a game and a half lead over Delaware, who lost earlier today, to Birmingham, and the Magic are going to go to Birmingham Tuesday and Thursday next week, but they'll stay atop the Eastern Conference standings. A hard-fought Osceola win, and they finish the road trip 3-1. 34 for Mac McClung, 24 for Trevelyn Queen, and an impressive second half showing, Chucky Atkins.
Yes, sir. An impressive second half. All the players stepped up and made plays. Mac McClung came out and had a big third quarter. Trevelyn Queen played exceptionally well. and Jet Howard got going in the fourth quarter, him and DJ Wilson to close it out.
Total 18 second half points for Jet Howard. Wendell Epps is going to talk with Mac McClung when we... Wendell Epps is going to talk to Mac McClung here in just a moment after they get through the handshake line, but the Magic shoot 53% from the floor. They go 17 of 36 from three. That was a big difference second half, too. Three balls just started to go down for Osceola.
Yeah, I mean, you know, anytime you're making shots, yep. You know what I'm saying, it's going to be a confidence booster. But like I said, the game in itself was a total team effort. These guys shared the ball with each other, a la 30-plus team assists, and the players made the plays they needed to make in order for them to get the win tonight.
Mac McClung is with Wendell Epps.
Thank you very much, Nick. Wendell Epps here with the player of the game, Mac McClung. Mac, 34 points tonight. You had 16 straight points in that third quarter. Just walk me through about that moment in particular and what was going on.
Yeah, I got hot and my teammates kept looking for me, which is, it shows the character that, you know, these guys are getting 4 or 5 minutes. These guys are getting their second string coming in, they're looking for me. That means a lot to me, and everybody's doing a great job. I was proud of everybody tonight.
You saw this exact same Long Island team last night, right? You were able to have a great performance there. You guys got the win. How special is it in this stretch of the season that you guys are able to beat a team two nights in a row just like this?
I mean, it's the expectation. I mean, with the players we have, with the star players we have on our team, we feel like we're the best team in the league. And if we don't stay in that number one spot and win the G League championship, then it's a letdown. So we're trying to just chop wood, carry water each day, keep going, and hopefully bring a championship to Osceola.
It's been another season for you to remember, of course, winning the dunk contest and now showing out here in Osceola. What does it mean for you personally to be able to showcase your versatility and your whole skill set on a platform like this?
Man, it's personal. I'm not, no ego, nothing like that, but, you know, me not being on a contract, like, it's personal. And every day I feel that. I come out to compete and show who I am, and I know who I am. So without my teammates, coaches believing me, I wouldn't be anything, but it's personal every night.
You're doing great things, Mac. Congratulations on the dunk. Back to you guys.
Our final score, 125-117. Magic win. McClung with 34 points. Our post-game coverage continues after this from Osceola Heritage Park. Magic winners here on a Saturday night in Osceola Heritage Park, 125-117, our final score. Mac McClung had 34 points, Trevelyn Queen a triple-double, 24 points, 14 rebounds, 12 assists, and Osceola continues its hold on first place in the Eastern Conference. We welcome you into our post-game coverage. I'm Nick Runowitz alongside NBA vet and the pride of Evans High School, Chucky Atkins. And Chucky, you and I were talking during the break. Of course, the Magic ride those four players in the second half, but a big difference, they kept the turnovers to a minimum, which meant more opportunities for them.
Well, we talked about that at the half, right? Mm-hmm. We said that the key to the second half and the Magic getting this win was the fact that if they were able to cut down their turnovers, right? They cut down their turnovers to six the second half. Again, Mac McClung got going. He gets hot. They continue to feed him. Trevelyn Queen, if there's anything such thing as a co-player of the game, with a triple-double. And, you know, you got DJ Wilson, like I said, and Jed Howard finishing it up. And it was a total team effort for those guys tonight. And it was a big win.
Four players in double figures. How about this? 34 for McClung, 24 for Queen, 23 for DJ Wilson. Jed Howard with 20. 18 of those 20 come in the second half. No one else was in double figures for the Magic as they shoot 53% from the floor and make 17 threes. And now the Magic head out on the road, final six games of the regular season. And Chucky, I know it's tough to boil it down to one to two things they have to do to continue to hold on to first place, but you watch tonight's game.
Right.
What does this team need to do to continue this winning streak?
Well, first of all, like we just said, keep your turnovers at a minimum, continue to play long stretches of great defense and make them, hold the other team to one shot. and continues to just share the ball with one another. Those guys are good enough offensively to where they can find out who has the mismatch and who has it going on any given night and ride those guys. So if they can continue to do that, they stand a good chance of finishing number one in the East and having home court.
Chucky Atkins, two broadcasts for you this week with us and two victories. It was great having you join us. And on a night where the Magic show up and they sweep the Long Island Nets in two games, they head out on the road in first place after a 3-1, 3-1 road trip. Our final score tonight, Osceola 125, Long Island 117. We'll talk to you soon. All right. Good job, man. That was fun. Good.
How much fun was that one?
That was going.